Okay, so the key to routing is choosing the output you want to route to first. So in this case, we just choose line out 1 and 2, which of course we have named speakers. And first I want to look at the panel for SD play. So I'm going to start playing some audio out of the SD card on the Aurora In. So SD play does refer to the micro SD card where you can do recording directly into the Aurora In. So if you do a multi-channel recording there, it'll play back on multiple channels. And the way that's organized by default is in a logical sequence. So for instance, out 3 and 4 is receiving signals from the third and fourth track on the SD card. Likewise, you know, 7 and 8 is coming from 7 and 8, et cetera, et cetera. So that's what you want most of the time, but there are some cases where it may be handy to change that. So let's say, for instance, you've done a multi-channel recording on the SD card, but you want to hear it out of your master output, your speaker output. Just simply unmute those multiple channels, and now they're all going to line out 1 and 2. Now, when you combine a bunch of channels like that, keep in mind you can start overloading the DAC, so you want to just attenuate if that's what's going on. So that's fairly straightforward. This is also very useful because, again, you have phones down here, and so you can route things to the phones. If you're doing a field recording and you have a bunch of channels, this is your secret weapon, so you can monitor all of them through the headphones at one time. So quite handy. Now the play panel is very similar to that, but this is going to be for streams coming from the computer. So I'm just going to get some things playing in Logic. Okay, so as you can see, you have a bunch of channels of playback going on now, and it's very, very similar. It's organized as you would expect it to be, where out 1 and 2 is coming from play 1 and 2, out 5 and 6 is coming from play 5 and 6, et cetera, et cetera. So again, similar cases where you may want to change that. Let's say you're organizing things according to stems, and you want a bunch of stems going to your headphone output. You would just select the phone output and unmute the channels that you want going there. And there's a number of other reasons. Sometimes one thing that's handy in a lot of cases where you have mixed analog and digital is, let's say play 1 and 2 is going to speakers, but I want to mirror that to the AES output because I'm going to do a confidence recording. Very simple, just choose AES out 1 and 2 and unmute play 1 and 2 so the same signals are going to both places. So pretty simple to use once you get your head around it.